I went to high school in a small town in Illinois, Marion, Illinois, and I played football there, and I played all sports. A friend of mine had a barbell set and liked weightlifting, and I wanted to get involved with lifting weights with him to become bigger and stronger. My dad, who was an All-American football player at James Millikan University in Illinois, thought weightlifting would make you muscle bound, and so he forbid me to lift weights. But he did allow me to bale hay and, you know, shovel coal and do manual labor, and that was his way of making somebody strong, was with very hard work. Luckily for me, I got a scholarship to play football at Notre Dame, and I went into Notre Dame weighing 165 pounds, but I was very quick. I ran a 48-second 400 meters. I was a 10-flat, 9-9 100-meter guy, and I could run 40 and 4-5. After the season was over with, you know, I went into Parsegian's office. Eric Parsegian was my coach, and he told me he wanted me to get bigger, get stronger, and that there was a gym at Notre Dame called Father Lang's, and that if I went down there and lifted weights and got my body weight up to, you know, 180 pounds or something like that, that I'd have a better chance of playing. So I went down to Father Lang's gym, and Father Lang taught the Olympic lifts. And he was a Catholic priest and taught us the Olympic lifts, and I became addicted to it. I went back to spring football, and I weighed 182 pounds, and they tested me in the 40, and I ran a 4.45. So from that time on at Notre Dame, and then, you know, after Notre Dame, I just stayed with the sport and loved it. This is our 1966 national championship team. My training partner at their wife had this made for me and gave it to me for Christmas. She gave it to me as a present, so obviously she's going to put me in the middle. Mm-hmm. It wasn't because that I was the great football player or anything like that. That's the 66 undefeated season. We were 9-0-1. That's the national championship season. There is a glitch in there that there was a 10-10 tie. They used to call it the game of the century. I don't know if they still do or not, but the next weekend we went to Southern Cal and beat them 51-0. And Michigan State, I think, went to the Rose Bowl and got beat by somebody. And so the sports writers said, it was the greatest team, the greatest game of the century, but Notre Dame's national champions. This is Father Lang. That was my coach. Of course, this was taken in the 20s, and he was a physics teacher at Notre Dame, and he played with Newt Rockne. This was the type of competitions that they used. This is Father Lang when he was still competing in. At one time, he was the fourth strongest man in the world. And there's one of my favorite strongman pictures is Father Lang. Right there, he's probably in his 60s. You know, it was one of the greatest times of my life. I still have dreams about Notre Dame and Ara Parsegian and, you know, the experiences Father Lang and we still have a what we call the Father Lang Alumni Board. Those are the guys that I trained with when I was at Notre Dame back in the 60s. While I was in college, I joined the PLC program. So that's platoon leader class in the Marine Corps. This was in 1965. And what happened with me was that I blew out my knee my junior year at Notre Dame. And so I was dropped from the PLC program and given an honorable discharge from the Marine Corps at the same time. I rehabbed my knee and went back into the PLC program. I blew it out again my senior year. So I'm 4F again. My defensive coach was a guy by the name of John Ray. And John Ray took the head football coaching job at University of Kentucky. And so I left Notre Dame, went to the University of Kentucky as his strength coach. And while I was doing that, I worked on my master's degree in exercise physiology. I was walking over to the huddle, which was like a student union, and the Marines were there. You know, and Vietnam's going hot and heavy, you know, and so I walked over and told them my story, just like I'm telling you. And they said, well, geez, coach, why don't you come back in? Try it. You can become the coach at the Quantico Marines. I said, what? They have a football team in the Marine Corps? Yeah, we play colleges. And you can become a coach at the Quantico Marines. That can be your MOS. And I said, okay. I was number one in my class at basic school. And they said, do you have your choice of MOS? And I said, well, I'm gonna be the football coach at Quantico Marines, so just give me infantry. 3 or 4 weeks go by, I graduate from basic school, and I get my orders, and it says Camp Pendleton, California. And I'm going, whoa, there's something wrong here. And I go up to my instructor, and he says, oh, we didn't tell you? What's that? He says, well, they dropped that football program. So I'm sure they knew that was in the works, but, you know, they just hook, line, and sinkered me, and probably the best thing that ever happened to me. Got out here, and I get my orders, and it's orders for First Force Recon. You know, at that time, it was 1st Battalion Recon. And so I got orders to 1st Battalion Recon, and I'm going, that can't be right, because it's a first lieutenant billet. I'm a second lieutenant. So I walk into my commanding officer's deal, and he says, well, I guess you're wondering why you're in this unit. And I said, yes, sir, I'm wondering why. And he says, well, as a commanding officer, I get the TOs, the task organizations, for the lieutenants that are coming in, and based on our needs. And I saw your name there, and I know who you are. And I'm going, excuse me, sir? He says, yeah, you're a football player at Notre Dame. And I'm a staunch Notre Dame fan. I walk into Camp Pendleton, and the first thing I had to do is swim 1,000 meters in the ocean. And I about had a heart attack. But I've always, in my heart, I've always wanted to be a Marine. When I was a little kid, I wanted to be a Marine, you know, so. That was just my calling in life, was that sometime I was going to be a Marine. Never even thought about the Air Force, the Army. And I got offers from the Naval Academy. I got offers from West Point, offers from the Air Force Academy. But no, it's, to me, the brotherhood of the Marine Corps, honestly, is like the brotherhood of CrossFit. That's why I think I'm so attracted to CrossFit. And they laughed at me. They told me I was crazy. He said, Burgener, it's gonna ruin your career. Football programs wouldn't run it because no one knew how to snatch and clean and jerk. But when CrossFit started getting involved, the stands started filling out and watching all through the whole event. Yeah, good job, just like CrossFitters do.